Hi guys, welcome back to Shine the Fine Art. Today I'm working on a watercolor seascape. I am working on the same series that is called Big and the Little. I have talked previously in a different video about the Big and the Little. I'll put a link in the video description so that you can understand what this painting is all about. If nothing else, this is still a seascape. So this time I've chosen to work with watercolor. You must have seen that off late I have been working quite a bit on watercolor. I usually used to work a lot on oils and different other mediums. Now I have picked up watercolor as well, and I'm trying to get my watercolor skills up to the mark I am with other mediums like oil and graphite and such. So you see that in this case I have masked off certain areas like the body of the little girl and the shell parts of the sea so that I can be messy with the rest of the painting, because in watercolors I like to do the wash kind of style. So I use a lot of water and do a lot of layers as well. I love layering no matter what medium it is. So to be able to do that, I have masked off the subject areas, certain subject areas, and then I am coming back and getting colors little by little in a certain area. I first started with the sky. Unfortunately, I missed out recording a little part of the sky, but you still get the idea. Now I'm working on the sea. First, I started with a very, very light layer. You will see that no matter whichever area of the painting I'm working on, I'm starting with very, very light first layer. And what that does is that it helps me to build up the darkness in layers. Because as I have explained in a video before, that in watercolor, it is you are able to build the darkness in layers. Excuse me. However, you are not able to lighten any area that you're dark. You are, but it is very hard to go from dark to light in watercolor. However, from going from light to dark is much easier. So I start with as light layer as possible and then slowly build up the darkness. And with the sea, you will see that certain areas I'm drawing some sketchy lines, then going over thin washes over it, and then drawing the sketchy lines again. Now I'm coming back and painting the beach area. Once again, I started with a very pale pink layer. Now I'm blocking in the shadow of the shell first, because that is going to be I want it to be darker than the rest of the sand, which is because of the sunlight. I want it to be very light. And I'm using sprays, paint sprays with the brush, and then I'm using dots and sketchy lines and different kind of textures to hint the sand and the unevenness of the sand and the ups and downs of the sand. Now I am starting off with the shell. You will see that initially I have left the masking fluid on, and then little by little I'll remove the masking fluid off and build on the darkness of the shell in layers. It is very important, no matter which part you are working on, to build in layers, from going from very light to the ultimate level of darkness that you want. And some of the highlight areas, I like the white to show through instead of trying to paint with opaque white or any other acrylic medium or anything. I let the white of the paper show through to show the lightest or brightest of highlights. And there you see I'm slowly building up on the shell itself. I'm going from light to dark, and the shadow areas I want it to be very dark, and the opposite side, the highlight areas, I want it to be very bright. And you see that if you have seen my oil paintings of the same subject, would notice that this has a very different style, but it still looks wonderful. Now moving on to the little girl, and also on this I started off with very light and then slowly building up the shadows, and some of the shadows I wanted to be really dark, and some of them I just want a hint of and I switched on to a liner brush for the details of the clothes and hair. And that's how I refine the details. You would see that I'm darkening the shadows under her body a little bit, and then there is the final painting. Let me know your thoughts and don't forget to subscribe. As usual, I'll put a link to all my social media presents in the video description. Please follow me to make sure that you know what I'm